Mississippi. No, today we're going back to the Klansman trial. Because more and more things are starting to reveal. Uncle C talked up on the stand. And now, to get to show the extent of just how dangerous some of these operations that Uncle C talk and C4 that take part in. Today, and I'm looking at this from the Jamaica Greener, but they basically talk about, you know, the incident where I think they never called the name, but based on the description, this sound like one time Sus and Razim were killed by Sita. Yes, that same Sus, that man top killer Sus. Right. Yes, the same Sus from the Hellshot. Yes. That operation is one of the spookiest operations Sita ever carried out. Now that we know the C4 was on it. The fact that they managed to kill Sus and Razim and not C4. This is mind-blowing. C4 actually left him phone. So, in other words, the phone call make. C tapped upon the other line. C4 upon one line. In the car with the Klansman members then, because they were going on a mission. It was a Klansman mission and somebody them got killed. But the whole time, C-Tac was listening to the conversation because C4 called him and left the phone line open. You can't make this stuff up. When we turn into this trial, the Netflix series, and I can understand what I'm talking about. So C-Tac was able to hear everything while going in the car. They were also able to trap the man them. That is why Sus and Razim could get catched by C-Tac. That is why C-Tac could pick out one of Black Man's top 87s. Over the years, Black Man, of course, you know, my boy for 87s running, but some of them, even by Klansman standards, stand out, right? If you just saw how brutish they were. You already know about Sci-Fi, right? He arguably did the most damage, but mostly against Tesha 87s then. Sus, a couple of the man they made up on trial now. But now that we know, say, C4 was actually working with. If you listen to my early videos when I said things start to make sense now, this is what is completing the puzzle. Slowly, the puzzle is being completed. C4 was working with C-Tac even from them time. Nobody couldn't see this. Nobody couldn't see this because this operation was so surprising to Klansman. That they couldn't wrap their head around it. All the police them know which part them have got. All the policemen them know which part. Right? For then, when time them escape from the scene, it was puzzling for everybody. Now we know why. C4 was already working C-Tac. This is a movie, yes, sir. This is a movie. And then the judge asked them, say, well, where are the phone recordings from the phone line then? As in from the phone companies there. And C-Tac, I say, they had to do their own recording. So one time, basically when C4 calls C-Tac and the phone line open, and they might hear the whole thing while going under the car, C-Tac was recording confidently, and for example, with another device. And the judge said, they didn't really want the information from Flo or DJ Cell. C-Tac said they were getting problems to get them. Even the judge said at one point, right, the law concerning how them get some information from criminal gangs and investigation need to be addressed. So I want the people in Jamaica to understand something. Uncle C-Tac, C4, and the rest of C-Tac plan an operation whereby C4 are going to the car with the Klansman them on a real killing mission. A mission where I got involved or possibly involved a shootout and did involve a shootout because Sus and Razim them dead after Klansman got them go. And C4 agreed to this. Now I don't know a witch, I'm telling already about this eagle eye. Imagine trying to convince somebody. Say, you're going to go on an operation with your gang. Call me and we're going to let the phone line open so we can hear what's going on and record it. it's very possible that since you're traveling with actual 87s and an actual Klansman mission, so one shootout going to start because police are going to try to assist them. Shot are going to fly all over the place. And in all of that, C4 agreed. That Negle Eye is special. And I want the people them to tell me something. Since this is nothing spectacular, because people are trying to downplay right, this whole C4 and C-tapping, let me ask you something. What somebody would have to do to make you go in a one car, go record some Klansman live in the Negle Eye mission, stay upon the mission, knowing say, police are listening and police are going to circle him and them after, and you are very likely to get caught in the shootout. What will it take to make you do that? Love? Money? Woke? What? Negle Eye? What would it take? Cause this is normal, right? People are trying to downplay this how extraordinary this whole thing is. A lot of things about this trial or this case impress me. Not just the fact that C-Talk never could see for, but the importance of the police then put on intel and covert operations. That right there, so, right, is what really going to shake up youngs in Jamaica. Remember the word then? Intel? As in intelligence and covert operations. 87s are expecting if you go up on them missions, if they walk into some police, they might have a shootout and then get it in laugh and say, well, they might have a shootout and then get it from police. If one witness to them, then go for the witness and then get rid of the witness. 87s are expecting that anybody who are going to testify against them is one person who walked down the road and spot what go on. Not easy for them, because them can just go for the person. Because them knows, alright, you see me, so I must you attack, or them corrupt police give them the information, and then go for the person. You know what? Sci-Fi is not expecting. He's not expecting that C4, or C5, or C6, in the car with him, or the phone line open, and seat up on the next line. He's not expecting, say, the whole time, police attract them. He's not expecting, so after him go, he might go book up by the police then on his return journey. You're simply not prepared for that. This case is groundbreaking. This case is the blueprint. It raised the bar to a point where now, when the next big young trial go on, and there needs to be many more, this is what we're going to compare it to, but we have to be realistic as well. Where C4 and C-Tapa do, understand that the average witness now do this. How you gonna convince a man? How much people you think you can convince? Say, left phone line open and then go on pan the mission. How much people think are gonna do that? Not many. But at least we know. So in a court of law, we get so many convictions, we see the levels. Information, the level of evidence that the police might come with, we can sink a gang the size of Klansman. We see it, so now we know. The DPP and our team, this is not just a case where them should have just, obviously they must work towards the conviction, but pure notes of your tech. Right, we need this, we need this. This wasn't solid enough last time. We never do enough of this. Should have done more of that. Right. The DPP, and the police, the C-TAC, the SWAT teams, they need to be educated on each other's job. Police need to know what the DPP need to get our conviction, and the DPP need the police same to understand so this have happened. Because sometimes, police the things and realize say, that now go stand up in our court of law. For example, with the old chain, the conversations, the phone records, at first, the police think they could just go in there and just one police just take it and just go talk. And the judge has said, and I saw it work. The judge is saying, it needs to be the exact same chain like what happened from C4 to Uncle C-Talk to the next officer to the next officer. So we need the police and the DPP team to depend on the same page. That way, when they collect them evidence, they know exactly how it will look. You don't want collect evidence for 5 years, and then when they reach in a court, The US say that's not admissible because I saw it work. So maybe I'm gonna get one smiley from each team to work with. Hey, maybe DPP have got send one or lawyer them if you attach to CETA. So, you know, spend a month. And then CETA send smiley. Long a month. Send a month down to the DPP office and them learn what I go on. They need to be on the same page. Because remember, in our court of law, a judge will say, alright, this will happen, but I like all this, right? I like the way I want to get it, I like how we want to pass it on, so throw it out. Because one thing that is very obvious is that enough police in Jamaica don't understand the law. Enough police don't know the law. They know the basics, but they don't really know the law. So when they do certain things, and they move this, pick up that, in a field of mind, they might say, this is a done deal. But the law down to the fine details say you can't do this and you can't do that and you can't do this. And then go to court and you say, this happened actually. Especially police like CTAC, when if you collect intel, they need to know the law down to the T. As a matter of fact, I'd go as far as to say, CTAC investigators should know the law as good as a lawyer. That way, if they depend on the operation and collect intel, somebody in the team, on the spot, can tell them, say, no, make sure you say this happened to him. Make sure you say, we have the chain start up. Make sure you say, when we get it from him, we pass it to him, I will store this, I will log this, I will put the data, so, and then, they need to know the law like a lawyer. Because remember, in our courthouse, it's not what you know, it's what you can prove. And what the judge is going to accept and dash out. Very interesting trial. But we're not keep watch. Anyway, Peter Scott, be up on yourself. Yeah, don't know, no life. Full Squad, see you circling. Bless.